One love.
Look at that. Absolute brilliant start there from Marlon. 8 hours and almost 20 minutes. Remember, he went through, he won the, already won the mixed doubles final. He's won the men's doubles final. And he's long now here in the semis. So he's gone, he's been as far as he can at the moment.
I think we should take a moment. We're going to see his time on court as well. Malong Pai time on court. Not that he was eating pie, but he has 3.141519. No, I'm just kidding. 3 hours, 14 minutes.
Love two.
Yeah, a third of the matches that his opponent has played. So that might level things up, given the head-to-head.
One, two.
Interestingly enough, today, Wang Chuqin has both knees with support on them.
I don't remember him having that earlier on, you know?
Taped up on the left, strapped on the right. I've seen him with the strap on the right.
Yeah. Don't remember that left one earlier on today when he was with Fan Zhengdong in the men's doubles final.
Yeah, his left hamstring, it seems, as well. Yeah. Some support there.
Again, I don't remember seeing that earlier, so... could be a consequence of that final.
3-2.
I would guess. In terms of tactics, one thing that makes Wang Chuqin so dangerous is that he's fast, he's fearless, and he plays near the table. He has a low trajectory drive, and he's not bothered by side spin. That's going to make it really tough here for Malong.
2-4.
They look to get into position early there. We talked about Malong and how well he's done against Chinese players. 68% win rate. Wang Chuqin, it's just 44%. Read into that what you will.
Three, four.
Yeah, it just goes to show you style matchup is a major thing. Meaning Malong can be dominant against the majority of his team. But he has one player with a very winning record.
That's classic, five, isn't it, from Malong? Steps around beautifully.
It's like the back of the table doesn't exist, the way he can dance around it and find the opportunity for that big hooking forehand. Yesterday, in all fairness, watching him play Lin Gao Yuan, I thought that could have been the end of his world championships career. Yet, he found a way through every single game until the last. The last one, he was a little bit more clear.
Awesome rally there. And you can hear the crowd reaction to it.
Again, it's like a concert. You don't know if you'll be able to see Ma Long perform again, and he's going up against the toughest battle he could possibly have drawn. It's a best of seven, so he's got a long way to do it. Now stamina is going to favor the man who's more taped up at the moment. The 23-year-old Wang Chuqin.
Yeah, Ma Long opted to just be in the singles. That's all he has here. Put everything on that.
I think that's smart. I think he's thinking about the team. I think he's thinking about protecting himself to make sure he can be in shape wherever he is needed. The chop block works. He digs in. In their recent history, Wang Chuqin almost never fazed by this chop block. Watch the spin here. Under and side, but how much of each? That's the question, and it comes back into the net.
Seven, why isn't he fazed by that chop block? Generally, by the chop block.
Typically, that's a great question. And if the world had the answer, everybody would be doing it. I think he reads it perfectly. He lifts. There's just a lack of fear. If Ma Long plays it shorter and lower, it's almost impossible to attack. But when it comes back, partially he's left-handed. The chop block naturally bends wide into his forehand, which gives him a lot of racket speed to add to it. A right-handed player is not going to have the same sort of opportunity.
Eight,
a race to
five.
The backhand corner here as Malong pushes deep and tempts. Wang Chuqin baits him into stepping around. I dare you, he says. And as low as he gets here. It's very close, but just the leg of Ma Long.
Yeah, it's coming into this Wang Chuqi now. 2 points behind. Yeah, you talked about bending that into the left hand of Wang Chuqi. Ma Long's got a very good record against left-handers overall, by the way. Just the 84%, you know.
Left, 6-8.
Although that is slightly less, I believe, than his career record. Yeah. What is he, 86, 87?
Left, 6-8.
Yep, 86, correct.
Also, the score on screen right now. What? Bum, bum, bum. Welcome to the Twilight Zone.
Very good. Just a point behind now, Wang Chuqi.
This is where Wang Chuqi really succeeds. He thrives on these open rallies. Short stroke, is able to pull from the middle with the forehand. Not easy to do. Ma Long can pinpoint weak spots on a player to make them uncomfortable, but Wang Chuqi has escaped that time and time again. 2 points on the trot now, and a second serve chance to tie it up.
How good was that from Ma Long on the backhand?
9-7.
Control game here. But even more than that, he adds to it. Look at the bend. Has to take his chances there. Ma Long plays fearlessly in that moment.
Just as Wang Chuqi was gaining on him, just about to draw level. Yeah, got himself to maybe a little bit of trouble earlier in that one, Ma Long.
Yeah, Ma Long turning the corner a little bit, depending on the forehand after the backhand he sets up, and it's played to the short side here. Clever play. Wang Chuqi rewarded for his bravery there. And quick thinking, really. Ma Long's backhand is one of the best in the world, but his forehand is better.
Big roar there from Wang Chuqi.
Just in case anyone wasn't expecting a fight, both of these players, remember, are going to be fighting for the same title for very different results. Wang Chuqi has never been the world champion in men's singles. And Ma Long has not lost a match at the world championships since the semifinals in 2013 against now coach Wang Hao.
Yeah, just the round of 16 so far for Wang Chuqi previously in the world champs.
Let. 9-0.
This is uncharted territory.
For me, this is massive for Ma Long because from a stamina standpoint and the recent history, he needs belief, he needs efficiency, and he needs to feel like he can get through this.
10-9.
And he takes the lead at the crucial juncture. First time in this game that Wang Chuqi is in front. And it's on game point as well.
From 5-8 down, a little help off the net there, the low trajectory, that's why he raises the hand. You can see it there, changes the timing. Game point now for Wang Chuqi.
Wang Chuqi takes the first game.
One love.
Yeah, Wang Chuqi now feel very good about things with the momentum very, very firmly in his way, in his favor. 7 of the last 8 have gone his way.
Love two.
What's he doing really well for you at the moment, Wang Chuqi?
Well, the same as usual. He's getting into focus. He's good near the back of the table. He's not anticipating. He's moving quickly. He's got short backswings, and he's picking placement on the table. He's using the wide forehand of Ma Long as a target where he can.
love, three.
Excellent work there again, Wang Chuqin.
Yeah, Wang Chuqin trying to dodge that, or Ma Long rather. Look, Wang Chuqin, 75% of his serves have equaled points for him. Ma Long, less than half. But I think Ma Long on that last serve was trying to cover his forehand by serving it short to the forehand of Wang Chuqin. The Chiquita, the banana flick, took that away.
Four, love.
Look, this is looking pretty dominant at the moment for Wang Chuqin, this second game.
It's funny, we talked about competing fan clubs when Zhang Jike and Ma Long were head-to-head. Even though Ma Long had a dominant record, a few big titles went the way of Zhang Jike. Meaning he would rise to the occasion. And that's what Ma Long is going to have to do here. Because from a motivation standpoint, from an energy standpoint, I mean, I'm already thinking about the Olympics in 2016, where Zhang Jike took Ma Long down to the wire in game one. And after that, it was just a runaway.
1-5.
Done.
1-6.
Wang Chuqin, beautiful. He's moving his opponent around, isn't he?
The last time they played, Wang Chuqin offered a handshake that was almost as if he was embarrassed to defeat his idol so steadily. Oh, look at this one.
Wonderful.
Six. Still got it.
Two.
That shot right there, as fast as can be. It is a thing of beauty. Watch the racket speed. One backhand just comes across the ball. From that camera angle, it looked even more effortless.
Six, you know, you mentioned three. The last time they played, when he shook his hand, Wang Chuqin, Ma Long's, and as you said, almost felt sorry about it. That was in Macau a few weeks ago, where you were in the WTT Champions. It was a game that was 11-1 in Wang Chuqin's favor.
Play, please.
I mean, that's a collector's item, isn't it?
It is definitely a rarity. Ooh, nice use of side spin front of the table, brushing up on that, saves himself with creativity. Ma Long with 3 points in a row. Let's take a look one more time. Patient. And in position. Nice combination there.
Yeah, put a lot on that, didn't he, Ma Long?
I guess if you're going to be patient, you have to be in position. That's the idea if you're not going for the big finishing shot.
He's been wonderful on the backhand. On the serve receive, excellent.
Yeah, no hesitation there, a clean read. Realizes the ball's going to clear the back edge of the table, which means he can unload, get a full swing.
Pumped
eight,
fist
four.
For Wang Chuqin, who leads by four.
You might think that Wang Chuqin, considering his record and the way he played last time, would be pretty confident coming into this, but he also has seen Ma Long throughout his career and knows that he has more to worry about than their last head-to-head.
Nine,
he put a lot into that, Ma Long, but it's Wang Chuqin who wins the point. Puff for the cheeks. It's a tough old match for him. He's trailing by five.
Four, ten.
No, still in play.
Still in play.
He wins the point. Ma Long wins the point. It hits his hand. I'm usually absolutely supportive of the officials, but this ball is still in play. Ma Long did everything right to play this through. The hand that holds the racket is part of the racket. Between the wrist and the fingertips, look at this save, and all is fair. Unbelievable
wow.
save.
What a point.
That is brains right there, and both of the players knew they had to continue.
Yeah. He stopped momentarily, Marlon, and then jerked himself back into action.
They called the score for the next point. They called it for Wang Juqin.
Six, nine.
Now imagine. Just imagine.
Is that the little catalyst for the comeback?
I'm sure plenty of basement players, bar players around the world would be asking, what's the rule on that? Between the wrist and the fingertips of the hand that is holding the racket is considered part of the racket.
Was it Anders Lind that was lobbing Wang Juqin?
Time out.
There's almost no one more well-respected than Ma Long.
Nine, eight.
It was the card has been played early by Wang Juqin in this match. Felt this was my opportunity to go 2-0 up. I don't want Ma Long ruining that for me. I've got to make it a little more difficult for him. Disrupt that momentum he's starting to build. He's got the first point, though, after the timeout, Ma Long.
Eight, ten.
He puts that away nicely. He's in the slot.
In terms of intention, if you do push the ball at this level, it's just got to be so precise. Not a bad push, but with Wang Juqin, he's expecting it long after that handcuffing serve. Ma Long, once he started to show push, Wang Juqin made his move for that backhand step around.
Two game points for Wang Juqin. Ma Long, you could just see that reaction. I think he knew it immediately.
Sure doesn't like to be bullied.
Went for the long serve.
He's got to dominate the short game. He's got to bait him into a softer opening.
Love one.
In 2017, when he played, and this is me, again, speaking on behalf of the greatest brain in table tennis and the greatest player in the game of all time. But I think if he can get Wang Juqin slightly off balance, off footing, in combinations, allow him to attack first. But one, this is good. One. Good movement. Short to the forehand side. Get him to play the push game. Ma Long's flick is going to have to be on here. No flick needed. Again, he's wonderful with the baseline of the table.
Two, one.
I just can't recall. It's been a long time since I've seen Ma Long push on the receive and manage to win the point. If it's a short push, yes. Long push, Wang Juqin is just too hot to handle. Not with any consistency, anyway. Moves him around well here after playing it to the short forehand side. A little bit of a chop block action leaves Wang Juqin under the table where he has to play a compromised shot, then play a little bit more defensively on that one forehand. Nice change of pace there from Ma Long in the end.
Two, three.
Wang Juqin just back in front. So to answer your question, of the three semifinals he was eliminated in, Ma Long, 2009 Wang Hao, 2011 and 2013 Zhang Jike.
Four, two.
And Juqin there, adding two more, adding another one to his tally, two ahead. Those are the winners, by the way, that I was mentioning, not who necessarily beat him.
Okay, that's a very important clarification to make. I was wondering, I'm looking at your screen, I'm thinking, how did you deduce that? Back edge of the table here for Wang Juqin.
Puts his hand up there.
Life is full of hypotheticals. What if Zhang Jike had won that first game in 2016 at the Rio Olympics? What if Ma Long had won this first game here?
2-6.
I think we'd be watching quite a different match right now.
if Marlong had won game one?
Yep.
When he had that lead?
Here's the thing. It's pressure that adds to the pressure Wang Chuqin already feels. And it's confidence that adds to the confidence that Marlong already has. But at this point, we're not going to see as much confidence. Their head-to-head is the same as the score on screen here. Yeah.
It is looking very good at the moment for Wang Chuqin. No response here from Marlong. The lead is now 5.
7-3.
I don't want to spoil any movies, but this reminds me of a very touching ending to a movie I just watched. But the finish of this match, it is still TBD. We don't know yet.
Let 7-3.
Oh, everything is going Wang Chuqin's way. I think that's the second one in this game alone.
Well, if karma is a thing, I think Ma Long's karma is going to have to start the engine soon. Some in the table tennis karma bank here.
It's a procession of points at the moment, isn't it, Wang Chuqin?
It's emotional for me to watch because one of the things that makes Ma Long such a superhero in the eyes of fans is that he always has this will. He can find an answer to almost everything. But this is the only player in my life where I've seen him look like he just can't find an answer.
Is this, Adam, kind of like the official handing over of the baton in a way? I know he's had a very good record, but here at the World Champs. Look, he's walking away. He walked away from that. Can he dig deep here? He really needs to stay alive in this match.
One love.
And that's kind of summing up how things are going right now. Wang Chuqin is just too good. There you go, just tapping his heart there. Wang Chuqin, I think he knows as well the gravity of the situation.
One, two.
Now, I've been calling Wang Chuqin the future world number one for a long, long time. There's just something about the quality of his game, his lion-heartedness, the way he never gives up, the power, the danger that he plays with. If he wins this match and takes the world championships, and if Fan Zhendong is eliminated in the semifinals by Liang Jingkun, we have a world number one. On screen now in red.
With the whole, all the permutations and the points and all that.
That's right.
So just repeat it again.
If Fan Zhendong gets beaten in the next match,
right,
and Wang Chuqin wins the world championships, we have a new world number one.
He will overtake Fan Zhendong. Wow.
That's correct.
Is that faster than you thought it might happen? I mean, if it happens, of course. This still has to happen. But if he does do this, do you think the trajectory for you has gone quicker than you would have expected?
Yes.
For Wang Chuqin?
Yes. If you'd asked me a few years ago, no. I think the new world ranking system, it moves so quickly and points expire so quickly, the world is still getting used to how volatile it is. Beautiful shot here, cleaning it up, getting him into the touch play. Not easy to do, but watch this. Ma Long touch very gently, keeps it short. And now he can follow and finish. When you asked me before, what can Ma Long do? Mm-hmm. The push game, if he can keep Wang Chuqin off the attack, his over-the-table game, Ma Long's is outstanding. He's tied back up 3 points apiece. It's a long way to go, but he's going to have to look at every point as its own war.
4-3.
This is a big point to win because it's in the open rally. The serve came along, Wang Chuqin taking that big swing for the first spin shot. And Ma Long putting the pressure on, it was directly into the backhand instead of on the elbow. Remember, Ma Long has not lost a match at the World Championships in 10 years. 2013 semifinals.
Yep, against Wang Hao, as you were saying earlier. Wang Hao, by the way, took a 3-0 lead in that one. Just like Wang Chuqin has. And then we had a bit of a comeback from Ma Long, won the next two before losing in the sixth.
5-all.
All square here at around the midway point of game four. Ma Long has to win this to stay in the match.
Let 5-all.
Wonderful. Quick return from Ma Long to win the point.
6-5.
Opening spin, short strokes on both sides. So this for me is what he did against Fan Zhendong in 2017 in Dusseldorf. He didn't always take the first attack. When he did, it didn't have to be the big one. Meaning he allowed the first attack of Fan Zhendong on many occasions just so that he could use it for positioning. Say, you take the bigger, more costly stroke. I'm gonna send it back while you're out of position and I'm gonna stay in position to wait for the good opportunity. Six of the last eight now favoring the Dragon.
Now the lead is three here for Ma Long. You can hear the Ma Long fans in there.
Eight, six.
Bit of a groan from the crowd. There will surely be sentimentality around. Let this last a bit longer.
Second bounce, the touch play. Ma Long fighting for survival. Which is a stark contrast, really, at the end of last game at 10-3. Mm. Walked away, yeah. Didn't even look back. Said, let's just get on with it, shall we? He was leading in game one, a crucial moment here.
And he's got four game points, Ma Long. Yeah, those Ma Long fans, hoping beyond hope. He can come back here, it's a tough one, but he can at least pull this one back if he converts a game point. Which he does. Ma Long keeps this alive.
Love one. Love.
There's another one, collector's item.
He's had his share over the years. We've seen world number ones. Again, it just goes to show you how specific the serve needs to be at this level.
Wang Chuqin's won both those points on Ma Long's serve.
Three, love.
Surges to three, love already. What are you feeling, Adam?
I'm feeling like, what if I were Ma Long's coach right now? He has to have the will to win. He has to have the belief. He exhales all stress. 0-3 down.
Yeah,
I just don't want to see him give up. It's a sad day if you see Ma Long give up. At the end of game three, it just felt, it's tough. I mean, there's a reason he's everyone's hero, including Wang Chuqin's. Wang Chuqin wants to win, but he doesn't want to see Ma Long give up.
Right. So let's see how he does in his serve this time.
1-4.
Finally gets one on the board. It's almost like preempting things, isn't he?
Say it again.
It's almost like he's preempting.
It's definitely a surprising shot. Comes out to push long to the forehand for a guy with one of the best banana flicks in the world. That would definitely be quite surprising for the opponent. That said, 2 points in a row now for Ma Long.
Deep shot from Ma Long. Wow. Three in a row.
This has been the question for me, again, since the draw. How is Ma Long going to do it? If he's going to beat Wang Chuqin, he's going to keep up the record he's had since 2015, how?
Left, 4-3. Three, five.
So that run comes to an end for now. Wang Chuqin up by two.
Left, 3-5.
Got to position early again, trying to play the banana flick. Wang Chuqin.
It's interesting listening to the crowd. Wang Chuqin with a massive fan club, but I feel like table tennis fans are Ma Long fans. It's just one in the same.
He's drawn level here. You can hear the Ma Long chance as well.
Taking his chances here with the angles. Ma Long going wide out to that forehand.
Six, five.
What would you say would be sort of the more competitive final at the moment if it was between Ma Long and Wang Chuqin against, say, Fan Zhendong? Assuming he wins this match against Liang Jingkun.
That's a great question. My internet's having issues in terms, I think they're going to be very close in general. I know that's a bit of a non-answer, but really, you can think of times in recent history where both have happened, where Ma Long has beaten Fan Zhendong and where Wang Chuqin has beaten Fan Zhendong, but Fan Zhendong has had the better record, I think, overall against both.
Yeah. That momentum has shifted firmly back towards Ma Long.
I think it's just a question of if you're ready for the next generation.
Six, seven.
Just remember, he was love four down. Ma Long. Just a point in it. Nope, doesn't make
eight,
it.
Seven, eight, six.
Pulling away.
We got some of our VIPs there. Michael Brown on the far left. Matt Pound in the middle, two behind WTT. All three VIPs there for you.
Left, 8-6.
Important moment here for Ma Long. Wang Chuqin moves three clear, and he's two away from getting into his first World Championship men's singles final.
The entire Chinese team watching on from the stands.
They will know the significance of all this right now. Ma Long nearly on the brink. And there are four match points here for Wang Chuqin. This is massive here for Ma Long.
Wang Chuqin trying to stay focused, play smart here, reminds himself to remain calm in these moments.
Survives one, that's a massive roar in the crowd as well.
7-10.
There's no question he's not gonna go down without a fight here. Ma Long still within arm's reach, 3 points away, serving to one of the best receivers in the game.
Wang Chuqin is into his first men's singles World Championship.